Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, we had discussed about the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure. I think all of you are clear with the concept of Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure. In this lecture, we are going to have a discussion on a problem based on Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure. Here, there are four signals given: S1, S2, S3 and S4. We need to find out orthonormal basis functions for uniquely representing these signals. Okay, so let us revise once the steps involved. Here are the steps. First is, we define the first basis function phi1 of t, which is given by s1 of t divided by square root of e1. Next, we'll define the coefficient s1 of t in terms of basis function we'll write, and our s11 will be square root of e1. That is second step. The third step, what we have, using s2, we define the coefficient s21. S21 is defined by this equation: integration from 0 to t s2 of t phi1 of t dt. Okay, after this, what we have is the fourth step. If we introduce the intermediate function g2, g2 is given by this equation. Okay, this is the one of the form of general equation of gi of t, okay, which we see in the next slide. So g2 can be calculated like this, but s21 we have already calculated, which we can substitute. This s21 we substitute here, phi1 also we have calculated. S2 of t is the value of the signal s2. Now we can define phi2 of t by this equation: g2 of t divided by square root of 0 to t g2 whole square t dt. Correct. Now we have got second orthonormal basis function. G2 values we substitute, and if we simplify this equation, we'll get this equation by using these two concepts. The energy is unity, and phi1 and phi2 are assumed to be orthonormal. Based on that, we arrive at this result. Now we have got two orthonormal basis functions. Since we have got four number of signals, there might be more than two orthonormal basis functions. So what is next? Next, what we have to do is, we will have to calculate gi of t here. Give me a second. For more than two orthonormal basis functions, we are going to calculate g of t function using this equation. Here I will be 3 now. Already g2 we have calculated. Next value of I is 3. g3 of t, here it will be s3 of t. J is equal to 1 to 3 minus 1, which will be 2. So this is the equation: Sij into, okay, this is into Sij into phi j of t. So if we substitute the Si values, Sij values and phi j values and Sit values and the summation of this, we will get gi of t. Then we will move back to phi of t or phi j of t equation. We will substitute for gi of t here, here it will be g3, again here it will be g3 of t whole square, and simplify, we'll get the third orthonormal basis function. Likewise, fourth one also we can calculate by substituting here 4 and simplifying this equation and finding out the coefficients of the signals and using them in correct form. Okay, how we can find coefficients? This is the equation to find coefficients. Already we have seen S21, how it is calculated. S2 of t multiplied by phi 1 of t dt integrated over 0 to t, where j is from 1 to I minus 1. I hope it is pretty much clear how to proceed with Gram-Smith orthonormalization for given signals. Now let us see the given problem and we'll solve this. Thanks for watching.